pie crust today and to show you how to do that. A lot of people are afraid to make pie crust, but don't worry, it's not hard, and it's going to be easy, and it's going to be fun. So we're going to start with flour.
All right, so we got, tell us what we have here, Donna, for our ingredients.
Okay, we have flour, we have shortening.
Mm-hmm.
I use Crisco, I like it, but I'm not affiliated with the company in any way. So. And we have a little bit of water that we're going to need to add in a little while.
Okay.
And right here I have a little bit of salt measured out, a quarter of a teaspoon, just a little bit to give it a little bit of flavor.
All right.
And you those are the basic ingredients that we need to make pie crust.
Okay.
Okay, some people use milk, but I use water for mine.
All right.
I put the 2 cups of flour into the bowl. Now we're going to add 3/4 cup of shortening. I'm just going to dig it out of there and put it into the bowl, just like that. Just as much of it in there as you can get. I'm going to use my fingers. Okay, now the shortening is in there. What we're going to do next is, this is very important. We have 2 knives here. And we're going to cut the shortening into the flour till you get to pea-sized little chunks. So that's going to take a couple seconds here.
Now, what is the importance of that?
The importance of this is so that the moisture of the shortening goes throughout the flour and makes for a wonderful pie crust. It makes the flavor good, and also the moisture is very important when you're making pie crust, because you're not going to add a lot of water because you do not want the pie crust to be tough. So this is going to create flaky pie crust. So we just cut the shortening in. Here's a little pea size there, but we're going to keep on going. We want it to be throughout the flour before we add the water. Oh, we're going to also add the salt.
Okay.
So I'm going to add that little bit of salt. Not too much, just a little bit. Okay, we're going to continue to cut that in. And I had this recipe. This was on the back of a can of Fluffo a long time ago. I don't know if any of you remember what Fluffo was. It's also made by Crisco. It's a yellower colored shortening. It has more butter in it.
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah, and that's where I got this recipe. It never has failed me yet, so we'll see. It's fun, too. Okay, now go like this. Now, we have that pretty well, but I'm going to be particular about it and kind of stir it from the sides. Okay.
Let me zoom in on that just so I can show everybody.
Now see how they've become a little bit pea-sized.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Flour's starting to mix. That's a little chunky, but that's okay.
Now, Donna, tell us how many pie crusts we can get from this particular recipe.
We'll have the top and the bottom layers. So you're going to get 2 crusts for each one.
Very good.
So we're going to make an apple pie, so we need all of this batter for that pie, or all this pie crust. If you make coconut cream pie or a pie without a lid on it, I call it, you know, without the top layer, then you would be able to make 2 pies.
Oh, okay. Very good.
It makes 2 shells.
That's good to know.
2 pie shells. Okay, now the water, as you see, there's 1/4 cup. You don't want to use more than that. You're going to sprinkle it just throughout the pie dough. Okay. I had a little bit more in there, so I'm not going to add any more than that. Then you take your fork, trusty fork, okay, and you're going to push it against the side of the pan as you mix. You just push it through there.
Donna makes it look so easy.
It's not hard. You just have to take your time. You get a nice bowl that you like, that you're comfortable with. See how it's going through the fork? That's exactly what you want. That's why you use a fork. A spoon would not do this. It would clump up too much.
That makes sense.
So see how it's starting to form? And you don't have to hit it real hard. Just take it easy with it. Be gentle, because you want it to be nice and light. But keep going around until it starts to form. See how nice? It's going to be good. And just keep going. See it pulling away from the bowl?
Yes, that's great.
Good. Okay. So it kind of does it itself. You're not really helping it much, just stirring.
And it looks like it's a good workout on your arm as well.
Yeah, it is. It is. It is.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen.
There we go.
You can make some pie crust for your morning
good exercise
routine.
A little aerobic on the arm.
Yeah, I say morning because it's morning.
All right, now, see how we have this nice...
It's morning when we're doing this.
Yeah, moist that is.
Yeah,
what
very
we're
nice.
What we're going to do now, take our hands in here, don't be afraid of it, and kind of just push it together and make a ball. And you're going to actually make two balls. Now, see how I'm kind of pushing that with my finger? Not hard, just gently. Okay.
Now, I have a question for you.
Yes.
Let's just say... Not that you would do this, but let's just say that you're not making a double crusted pie. You're going to make a pumpkin pie, or you're going to make a cream pie of some sort, or a pudding pie.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't want to make two.
I see.
So you've got extra pie crust left. Could you refrigerate or freeze the leftover?
Yes.
For
now. Oh, absolutely.
Okay,
absolutely.
Very good.
Just make sure you get a good freezer bag so that your pie crust does not get any frost from the freezer on it, because that will ruin it. But you can, I think up to 2 weeks, someone told me.
All right, that's a good tip.
Yeah, so you can make it ahead. Now, see how we split them up? These are good.
It looks great.
Look how great that is. Now, look.
And it looks so super easy.
It is. And it's soft. I've never actually made it where it hasn't worked. So this method that I've just shared with you, it always works for me. So as long as you use those knives and get your pea-sized chunks before you put the water in, you're good to go. And this is very pliable. As you can see, it's going to come out really nicely as far as making a crust. So we have two of them. And then we're going to start now to roll them. That's our next step.
That's awesome.
Okay, we have the two now that we have separated the dough that we've mixed. And we're going to take one of them and use it. But the other one, we're going to cover it up with a towel so that it doesn't get too dry between the time that we roll this one and the time we roll that one.
Okay.
You want to keep it nice.
And you don't need to take time to let it rise or anything.
No, nothing. Nothing like that.
Just asking.
Okay.
In case somebody would want to know.
Now we have this nice butcher block surface. You can roll this on anything. Anywhere that you like, you know. If you want to put, like, cellophane down or something, that's a little more difficult, though. You know, I found if I put a cellophane paper down.
Mm-hmm.
So I just use this surface, put some flour down.
I've mentioned before, too, that Donna has this wonderful butcher block surface in her kitchen. It's just amazing
to be able
to do things like this on.
It's really nice. And then you put a little bit of that, the flour onto the rolling pin. And I like this one because it's wood. It really works good.
Nice.
But a lot of folks have ones you can fill with water, all kind of things. So whatever you like. And then we just start to roll.
I have a marble rolling pin.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Got it as a wedding
whatever
present.
Whatever you like, you know, whatever you're comfortable with. And I just add a little bit of flour as we're going along. Not too much, though. Don't go crazy with that because you don't want to make it tough. Keep that always in your mind that you want the pie crust to be nice and flaky. So what you don't want to add too many things as we're going along here. I'm just going to roll it. This one's real easy because you don't want it to stick. And you can kind of do like this a little bit. And we're going to work our way out from the center out. Best way, I found, so that you don't see how that's starting to do that. So you don't want to raise up the sides and crack your So if you can, prevent it. I just keep it a little bit floured. And keep going. Just rolling it out. You can even sing a song if you want. Rolling, rolling.
We could sing Rolling in the Deep.
Yes, you could. Or In the Deep Blue Sea. And I see how you just... Keep that nice and powered. See, it's getting a little bit bigger now. And it doesn't matter if it's not completely round. Don't worry about that. Because we're going to take care of that.
Oh, I just thought of another song. Rolling on the River.
Rolling up. Proud Mary, huh?
Yeah.
Rolling
Proud Mary.
Yep, that's it. Now, see how nice it is. You want it to be...
Rolling on the pie crust.
There you go. We promised you a little song. There it is. Last video.
When you go down to Donna's, I bet you're going to make some pie crust to eat. You don't have to worry if you don't know how to do it. Donna's going to show you just how easy it is.
That's
rolling
good.
Pins keep on turning.
She's got it together, hasn't she, folks?
Yeah, she's proud and keeps on rolling. Rolling, rolling, rolling on the pie crust.
Hey, not too many people get that song. You should feel privileged. Okay, now, we have this rolled out pretty nice.
Nice, okay.
Now, we're going to take...
My bad.
Knock the other one over.
I almost knocked the other one over, yeah.
We're going to take, this isn't a science, but we're going to take this pie pan.
Ooh.
This is what I'm going to use.
I see what you're doing there. Okay.
Size it up. Okay, and I think we look pretty good. Now,
okay.
Remember, it's kind of like pizza dough. You can use a little bit of shaping as you go along. When you put this into this pan here, you're going to be able to form it around the sides. So if it's not exact, it doesn't matter. But that's pretty good.
All right.
Okay?
Yeah.
Oh, and actually, that's not the one I want to do. Oh, sorry. Okay, now, I take my little turner, because this is the part where people get really nervous. You know, because it's like, how am I going to get that from here to here without breaking this little part?
Show us how, Donna.
So this is what I do. And Dina could sing to you while we're doing this. You just kind of lift up the edges.
I'm trying to think of a lift-up song.
Good luck with that. And see how we're going under it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Just don't get too industrious like I just did. Take it easy. Take it easy.
There you
Take
go.
Take it easy. Don't let the sound of your own wheels drive you crazy. Take it easy. Okay, now we're going to keep on going. Lift it up. Yeah, it's going under there real nice.
Perfect.
Yep. So I used to really stress over this. Oh, this was horrible. But not anymore.
So basically just take your time with it.
Mm-hmm. There. Now it's all lifted.
Okay.
Oh, the magic is coming. Here we go. I'll take it up.
Oh, look at that.
Right in. Really nice. And then we'll position it.
Oh, question. You didn't have to prepare your pan with any...
No.
Oh, I know why. Nothing. Because of the Crisco.
Exactly.
It basically does not need any oil or spray of
Don't
any kind.
Don't put anything on that at all.
Okay.
No. Just go with your pan as it is. Okay, now see how we have a little bit too much there, a little bit too much here. So we're going to do, we'll pat down the bottom part first, gently. Treat it nice. Then we're going to take this off, like that, and we're just going to put it over here.
Oh.
Like that. See? Now you can get a little bit of water. Get some water. Just a little.
Look how good that looks already. It looks really wonderful.
Okay. Now the water acts like glue, and you just put a little bit of water between the pie crusts, just a tad, and it keeps it there nice. Dip your finger in the water, put it on one side, and you can even put it over top like this to see how that seals it.
Nice, yes.
Oh, nice. Okay, now we have another little spot here. We're going to wait on that for a minute. We've got a big one over here, so I'm just going to take that off like that. And we're going to put that right here. It's kind of like glue and stuff. Here we go.
Yeah, it kind of reminds me of... I don't know if you ever took a pottery class, but...
Oh, yeah. Sort of like that.
When you do
hand
throwing on or hand building, excuse me, with pottery.
Yeah.
And you use the water with a little bit of the clay, it makes what they call slip.
Oh, slip. Okay.
So that's basically what you're doing with pie crust.
Very similar to that.
Yeah.
And I'm just trying to... take, you know, as much as I can. And then here's a little bit right here. So we're going to take the extra off of there. Okay. And we're going to split it between here and there.
Okay.
Best we can. cut it out. That little piece. Spread it out too, right across here. And just being real gentle with it too, like I said. Take your time. I'll take this little piece here.
Our hubbies are going to be so happy to have pie tonight.
Oh, my husband loves pie.
Donna is making, as she said, an apple pie. You're giving that one to a family member, correct?
The apple pie?
Yeah.
Or no, that one, the family member is my husband.
Oh, okay. So you're making the apple pie for your hubby, and you're also making the coconut cream. And I am going to be making a coconut cream for my hubby. So when I go home tonight, Jimmy is going to be so excited to have coconut cream. Actually, it's probably not going to be tonight when I go home, but you never know, because when Donna and I get together, my goodness, we could be together from morning until night, and
sure,
we never run out of things to do or talk about.
It goes fast, I'll tell you. Okay, now, see how we have this? Our things are pieced in there pretty nicely now.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you can get a little bit extra by doing, like, pizza. See how rib it out a little bit.
Good
idea. And the top layer is going to go over top here, and when you get done with that, and we'll show you that maybe, we'll be squeezing these edges together so everything will fill in very nicely. That's what we have so far.
Looks good. So Donna has put together her apple pie, and she is now putting the final layer of crust on top.
Okay,
it looks so good. She's going to get some water and
make our glue again. And I get my little stool. This sometimes takes a few minutes, so I like to sit down. Alright, here we go. So just take the top part, lift it up, and put the water between on top of both sides, and then you're going to pull off the extra, like we did before. Whoops, that was the oven. The oven's ready. The oven is set at 365, because I was trying to think, 350, 375, so I went halfway in between.
Okay.
Because the apples are raw, so it takes a while. I don't have a filling in here, it's actual raw apples, so that would make a difference. So if you have a filling that comes out of the can, then you can cook a little cooler, 350, and it probably will be done sooner. But I do 365 for about an hour. Now, when you run into something like this, if you have a little, you can just fold that over.
And as you can see, too, there's a large, almost like a mountain in the middle of that pie, and that is because she has chosen to use the fresh apples so she can really build it and make a really nice, yummy.
And that will cook down
pie
a little bit, probably about that much. It'll cook down about an inch, I guess.
Now, will you put any fork marks or?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. And that's important to do as well.
Mm-hmm. Because you need a little bit of a venting so that the juice can, you know, the heat can escape and it won't bubble up over the edges as much. But these do have a tendency to bubble into the oven. So we were just discussing, we were going to put down aluminum foil underneath on the rack below this so that it doesn't go all over the oven.
And you would prefer doing that rather than setting it in a baking pan of some sort, because Donna had said that this way the heat of the oven can kind of circulate around the pie and cook it to its best ability.
Exactly. That's right. I'm going to just spread this out. It just takes a little while to make it nice, you know. This is a 10-inch pie pan. If you have a 9-inch pie pan, it would probably fit just a little better. But I like to make 10-inch with the apples, so you have enough apples and everything in there. The flavor's good. You know, it's a little bit larger of a pie, so you put a little bit more fruit in it, you know. But it turns out good. But the 9-inch pan, your crust would fit a little bit better. You know, this one's a little bit stretched, but it's still nice. We're almost there.
And I want to sing, bye, bye, Donna's making a pie.
That's good. That song's pretty long, too. That would be long enough while the pie's cooking. You could sing that song till the That was five done. Sorry, Donna.
She's got her oven on the timer sent to 365.
That's good. See, Dina can sing about anything.
What'd you say, an hour?
Yeah. 1 hour.
So you just put it in for an hour and wait. Then you really have a pie that is great.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you really have a pie that is great.
Oh, sorry, that wasn't good, honey. I'll try. Then you put little, if you want to do this, see how you can do the little fluted edge with your fingers, two fingers together, between. See how that's sticking up?
Yeah.
Just go like that and push it up. That makes a nice edge as you go along. This is the last step.
Groovy.
Yes, exactly. Slow down, you move too fast. Gotta make the morning last. Just kicking down the cobblestone. Looking for fun and feeling groovy. La di da 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 da. You know it.
Yeah.
You know how that goes. See, singing pie makers? Hmm. Quality video here. I'm going to stare. And I'll tell you what, whoever gets to eat this is going to be good.
We got a DIY of us making a pie.
Now, what I'm going to do is get a fork, and I'll show you what we'll do then. Right
back. Ooh, that looks so yummy. I'm going to try to zoom in just a little bit. Look at that. Gorgeous.
Don't know if you can see, but it's very flaky. You can see that right there. Okay, here we go. So we just put a few vent holes, is what I call them. And you can make it like a little pattern if you want to make it look nice. And when this browns all up, all of this crust will see how you can see some of those areas where we defined it. You won't see that anymore because all the crust, the shortening inside the crust will melt and everything will really go together nicely.
So you won't even need to put any butter or anything on top of that, correct? You just put it in the oven?
Right.
Now, is there at any point in time that you would need to put tin foil on the pie?
At the very end of the cooking time, if you notice, and it may or may not happen, it doesn't happen every time, if you notice that your edges here are getting a little bit browner than the rest,